I'm Paul, One Man, One Dog Electric. So, yesterday I hit 1,000 subscribers, so buzzing, and I made a video. That's the last video uploaded, and I say at the end of it that the day ended in disaster. I went out on the e-scooter, the Cabo Mantis Lite Plus, and it was a bit wet, and I hit a grid, and I come off, I fell on my hands, I bruised both my wrists, and my hands are hurting, my thumbs are hurting. I've also bruised my shin, I've got a big swelling on my shin, and yeah, I didn't wear protection, shin protection or arm protection, so school by error, I'm in agony, so yeah. So I've got the e-scooter there, and yeah, it just slipped from underneath me. I hit the deck, and I was in the middle of a road, lucky no cars was coming or out like that, so really lucky. Just in a bit of pain now, but it's made me think, yeah, right, that don't get used until I get some decent tyres on it, and I'll have to do a bit of research on my tyres. So while I'm in agony, I've got puppy flow, I need to still walk her, so while I'm resting in between, I'm going to get the Yadu 5 and I'm going to show you what I've done to that. And basically this is going to be a video on building the Yadu 5 back into an e-scooter, and yeah, it's a lot safer. I wouldn't have come off on that corner that I come off on. Rode it loads of times, used e-scooters for years now, never came off fair, was doing 3 mile an hour and it really hurt, and yeah, this just slid from underneath me, and the DIY Yadu 5 wouldn't have done that. I've never done it on e-mountain bikes, it's actually the first time I fell off, and yeah, right on my doorstep, so okay, so I'm going to just show you the Yadu 5 now, because I've converted it back into a kick scooter. I was going to sell it and sell the e-bike parts, but I've decided that that's safer, it's a better ride, and yeah, I've not fell off on that, and yeah, it just feels a better ride. So out of the two, I'm sorry, but the Yadu 5 wins, converted as a 1000 watt DIY e-scooter with a Violamart front wheel kit. So never fell off, like I said, and yeah, second go on that, and I'm falling off, hurt myself. I know it was my fault not wearing protection, but I still would have hurt my wrist and my ankle, even though I had these boots on. So right, okay, quick update, and let's get into building my sea scooter. A Yadu 5, and it's a kick bike or kick scooter, and I've shown it before in my videos. I actually converted it once already into an e-scooter, and that's how I know this one was a much safer ride, and yeah, I did some more adventurous stuff on this as well, and never come off, never even nearly come off, especially on a simple corner, and yeah, never hurt myself on it. As you can see now, it's got no grips on, it's all set back up as a kick bike, and I was gonna sell it, and I was gonna sell the e-bike parts and cash in my money and this is why I got the Cable Mantis Lite Plus, and I was going to sell this, and that idea has come to a halt. So this is much safer, like I said, so I'm going to convert it back to an e-scooter. So there's the front suspension forks fitted, so original stem, original handlebars, added more spaces here. These are Sunto XCT, I might be wrong, I'm not sure. So next is get the wheel and get the wheel on, and I'll catch up with you when I've done that. Okay, so that's a 1000 watt Violamart e-bike front wheel, and yeah, it's fitted to the suspension forks. Sorry, you can hear a bit of noise off the road outside. It's midday, what time is it? 10 to 11 in the morning. What we had with this was this caliper here rubbing on the disc on the wheel. I haven't put the disc rotor on yet. I've just put it on like this so I can get it wired up. There's a 20 inch 2.175 back tyre, and it's a Michelin Mambo. Right, so that's it, it's converted, it's all working, the front wheel works, the electric works to it, it's 48 volt, 16 amp hour, high long battery. So I need to tighten my wheel up and I'll show it working, but I want to make sure that the wheel's on completely tight and correctly, which it seems to be. All the electrics, the controller is inside this bag. I've got to fix the display. The two nuts have fell out of the back, and yeah, I need to fix it in place. They need cable tying on. So that's it, done in a day, and I'll show it working later, like I said, what I tighten my wheel up. Okay, catch up with you in a bit, but project finished. So it's 11 a.m. on Saturday the 10th of October 2020, and the Yadu 5 DIY 1000 watt e-scooter, what the video's been about, was done yesterday. It was all finished last night. I did all the finishing touches. So you've got the display, you've got a thumb throttle there, controller, and all the wires are in this bag. I've put safety pins there to keep the zip closed, because last time when I rode about on it, this kept on coming undone with the movement of the wires. So safety pins there to keep it held on tight. So cable tied on the forks, the wheel tightened up, the brakes don't rub, and we work. Eyeball Paul. Little mud guard to keep the mud off the battery. The caliper brakes work fine, got my back brake really tight. So I just want to now show it next to the Cabo Mantis Lite Plus and show you the different riding position and why this one, I think, in my eyes, is miles safer. So, right, as you can see, the Cabo is much shorter. The riding position from the footboard to the ground is like 3 times, 4 times higher than the Yadu 5 DIY 1000 watt. If you look at the handlebars as well, you can see that the Cabo is a lot higher as well, so you stood more upright and you're higher up as well, so more chance when you fall you're going to hurt yourself, and there's more chance to fall because you're off centre. You stood higher up, and yeah, you understand the laws of physics, easier to fall off. So I'm going to wait for my leg to heal now. It's feeling a lot better today, and yeah, I can move about a lot better. So I'm going to wait for it to heal, and then I'm going to go a ride on the Yadu 5 DIY 1000 watt e-scooter that I've built, and yeah, go for a ride and finally see if I can get down to Borsha Clough, because that's all I wanted to do the other day when I fell off. I wanted to go Borsha Clough and try out my 360 camera down there and do a bit of a time lapse. So that's all I want to do. So you'll catch up with me in my next video, going on a ride on my DIY scooter. And yeah, the Cabo will be just put to one side, put in storage until I decide to get some tyres for it. And we'll see with this DIY one how good this is and how much fun and adventures they have on this. So, okay, you've been watching me, Paul, One Man, One Dog Electric with Puppy Flow, the DIY dog helping me out. And yeah, okay, thanks for watching. Bye.